it probably shouldn't even be called meat because it's in vitro. Mm-hmm. Would you consider that a potential for your vegetarian diet?
Though personally I have no craving for meat, I'm extremely enthusiastic about the potentiality of in vitro meat, because unfortunately there is no argument against moral apathy. One can argue to one's blue in the face, but at the end of the day many people will just shrug their shoulders and say, but I like the taste of meat. Now one wouldn't consider this a satisfactory rationalization of child abuse. Whether it should be considered a satisfactory rationalization of animal abuse is another question. But if we are really to have global veganism or in vitrotarianism, I think it is essential to further develop and commercialize in vitro meat. And one definition of transhumanism, if you like, is technical solution to ethical problems. Now, I suspect you might be skeptical that most people would be prepared to make the transition to something as unnatural as in vitro meat. But recall, it's not, or it needn't be, genetically engineered. And in many ways, it's, inverted commas, more natural than today's factory farmed products from live animals. So, yes, I think there is going to be an in vitro meat revolution. And once, for the most part, we have made the transition, I think our grandchildren are going to be appalled and incredulous that we could have treated sentient beings in the way we did.